right. Well, in the new film, The Warrant, we follow a father and son who, after finishing fighting in the U.S. Civil War, find themselves having to deliver an arrest warrant to an army buddy. But it doesn't go as planned, as they find themselves trapped between two rival gangs and possibly reigniting the war once again. Take a look.
We gotta hold up until we get reinforcements.
How long is that gonna be?
Well, it'll take people 2 hours to get to town, 2 hours to posse up, about 5 hours to get back in the dark.
So till dawn?
I ain't waiting that long.
And star of The Warrant, Neal McDonough, is here with me now. Welcome.
Good morning. Thank you very much for having me on.
Yeah, I'm from Georgia, and there's a town called McDonough, Georgia. And I was
right. I tried to get down there. I wanted to buy all the swag. I wanted to buy sweatshirts for my 5 kids and my wife. But we just didn't have a chance. Next time we go back, hopefully we'll be doing Warrant Part 2. I'll get down to McDonough for sure.
You got to do it. Oh, wait a minute. Warrant Part 2? Is that happening?
That slipped. Did I just say something? Was that slipped?
You heard it here. Exclusive. You're one of my favorite actors. And when you come on the screen, I know it's about to get 10 times better. It's usually in a situation where you are playing a bad guy. Now sure. You're playing a good guy in this movie. That must be refreshing for you.
Yeah, it's for, you know, I love playing the good guys. However, as you know, many people know, I won't do sex scenes. So that kind of eliminates all the good guys because you're always kissing the girl at the end and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And then when I read The Warrant, I saw that wasn't in there. And, you know, when Doug Butts and Gary Wheeler came to me and said, we want you to star in this movie, it's a Western. And I asked the question and they said, nope, you don't have to do any of that stuff. Yeah. It's nice to be able to turn to a network like INSP and see, okay, they do make shows still about heroes who have to get through problems like we all have to get through.
Yeah, good stuff. Well, I want to talk a little bit more about The Warrant, but I guess since you brought it up, I do have to ask you about this policy of yours of not kissing, you know, and not doing love scenes. You know, now you're in big demand. I mean, are they willing to rewrite scripts for you? How does it work?
I think that my relationship with God really kind of sails me through things. And sometimes you take it on the chin every once in a while. And that's part of being human. I think we've seen enough people, you know, doing that stuff on screen that's not that important. The important thing is overcoming situations and being heroic in a movie like, you know, The Warrant.
So let's talk about The Warrant. I mean, you know, it's this Western. It has some history built into it. What was it about this role and this production that made you want to be a part of it?
Well, I've always wanted to be in a Western. My favorite shows as a kid were shows like The Rifleman or Big Valley. And, you know, I loved those shows. I loved the simplicity of the way the stories were told. It's family first, me second. And that's how I kind of run, you know, Reveille and I run our household that way.
The way that you all decide to deal with violence in this production is really interesting. Can you talk about that a little bit?
You look back at the old Westerns, you didn't see blood and gore all over the place. And I think that's, we're trying to harken back to those types of shows. You know, this is a pretty simple family drama when you really think about it. It's me and my son going out and taking down an old friend of mine who's gone bad. And I try to help him through it. And by the end, you know, we do the right thing.
Well, I want to talk about some of your other projects. What can you tell us about Two Men and a Pig? I really want to know about this.
My friend Ted Collins has put this really great, funny, harkens back to those 80s types of movies where I'm a hitman, kind of like The Professional. And about halfway through the film, I have a call of faith and I have to turn my ways into being a good guy and saving this young kid. So we wouldn't go down a path like I've gone down. And
let's also talk about They Might Be Kennedys, based on a real story. What can you tell us about that?
This movie is just hysterical. It's you know, about these guys who, you know, growing up in Cape Cod where I grew up, you know, the Kennedys were everything, and so many guys would pretend that they were Kennedys for all kinds of certain reasons.
So let's talk about Damien Dark, who is back.
Damien's just delicious. That you know, we really found the humor and put, you know, we Neal McDonough the character up a little bit, made him a dad and made him goofy and telling bad dad jokes all the time, like I do.
Yeah.
So for me, it was really such a fun time. And that's just great to play these villains because, you know, I have 2 sons, but I also have 3 daughters. And when boys start coming by the house and they realize that I'm the dad, they would be so scared to do anything to my girls. So that's really why I play villains. That's the real thing.
Well, I want to let everybody know that you can watch The Warrant. It is streaming on Vudu and also streaming on Amazon, and it's available for purchase at Walmart right now. Neal, such a pleasure to talk to you. Stay safe and sane, and thank you for your time.
Thank you very much. God bless you, and God bless everyone out there. Thanks so much.